Chapter 10, Palma. Excerpt from the Citizens' Assembly on the Raising of Taxes on the Gridlock, Report Number 66. Testimony from randomly selected citizen, Mr. Liu Mako. The lowering of tax rates over the years was just common sense. Ensuring investment into the gridlock meant that we could fund more research into better mechs. Increasing it would ruin all the funding because doing so would upset the incentive for investment into the cars. The mechs are the lifeblood of our hope. I'm against the raising of tax rates. Palma followed Rulo and Saga through the trunks towards the end of an alleyway. He had to choose a mech for Flora. His eyes darted around, taking in the strange sights and smells. He'd been in the trunks a few times before, but it always felt like a dismal horror theme park ride. Exciting, unknown, and scary. He struggled to agree with their plan, going against his parents to hack into the Mech Institute servers. Helping Mason also gain control over the car markets felt wrong. However, he knew he had to help. He was responsible for finding the forging job and giving it to Esper. He knew that Flora might not like him helping, but it felt like the right thing to do. Approaching a large door in the trunks, he could smell things burning and hear the distant noises of clanking metal. Rulo briefed him. Okay, to recap, prepare your ears, it might be loud. We'll quickly walk through and then onwards to Mother Mech. We convinced her, Saga interrupted. Rulo nervously chuckled. It's always good to have your sister as backup. Saga rolled her eyes and wrapped her arms over her chest. He thought he could convince Mother Mech with his inimitable charm to give us a training mech. He didn't want to reveal we were working for Flora because she might charge us more. She just straight up rejected him, Saga said with a laugh. So of course, I just went in, laid down the truth, and just like that, she said she would give it to us without any upfront payment. Which is weird, I know her, and she wouldn't just— He clearly didn't know her, Saga said, unwrapping her arms. Okay, well, whatever, it worked, and I helped, Rulo said, turning towards Palma. So anyway, she might be a bit intimidating to you, but she is chill. She manages the mech hall and does banking for the mechanics. We'll look at some of the mechs, and you need to choose what you think is best for Flora. We have some good news. Drumroll. She is also giving us a championship mech if Flora needs it. So yeah, two for one. Good deal. Palma nodded, not entirely sure what he got himself into. You'll need to tell me what I'm looking at. I trust your judgment. Rulo smiled at that, dusted off his shoulder pads, straightened himself, and opened the door, leading the party into the mech hall. It was an old parking garage that was now lined with mechs instead of cars. The lot was awash with the sounds of metal clanking and the smell of oil. Palma followed with his hands over his ears. He assumed this is what the inside of an engine sounded like. Smell that? Rulo said, taking a deep breath. It's the lubricant of hope. Rows upon rows of mechanics were hammering away at metal. A few of them greeted Rulo. Saga smiled at her brother. Random clanks and explosions startled Palma as he followed them through to the end of the hall. He wondered whether he should have splashed some dirt on him to fit in. They kept walking until a door at the end of the hall was the only thing they could see. Saga opened the door, and they walked down a long hallway in what felt like a dragon's neck, heat pulsing from a massive furnace. When they entered the room at the end, a woman with wings made of metal stood in front of a giant furnace. Hanging from the metal bones were tools, clanking together as feathers. It seemed almost bionic, like she was part mech, part human. She turned around and straightened her ponytail. Good to see you, my dears. And look at you, Palma Emmer. So nice to see you. I assume my dear friend Rulo and his smart sister informed you of what I do? I'm Mother Mech. I bank the mechanics and I fund research for new mech tech. You could think of me as the Trunks version of the Mech Institute. The only difference is that we have a bit more liberties down here. Ask Rulo, she said, winking at him. Rulo nodded with a chummy smile. Come. She led them past the giant furnace to a hallway lined with what looked like cells. Behind the bars were various mechs, stored for parts or future usage. We've got everything down here. Mechs with missiles, mechs with larger caravans at their backs, mechs with super boosters, mechs with remote access, mechs for construction, the works. As you know, I hope you know, Most mechs are hybrid. Fuel is for the jets. The rest is electrical. You'll need your own fuel. You want a training mech and a championship mech, correct? This way. I think I have just the right options for your consideration, Mr. Emmer. Palma felt a bit overwhelmed, the jail-like atmosphere tied to a buffet of choices. It felt like he was back in the flower shop, uncertain of what bouquet to buy. I present you with these three options. They're mostly the same. It depends what Flora wants in her, style of running. Lighter, more flexible, to bulkier but stronger. Have a look. They all look nice. Palma remembered the pictures in the manual. Some moves definitely required a bulkier mech, but he wasn't sure if that's what Flora wanted. Like in the flower shop, he pretended to know what he was doing, looking at the mechs. Rulo and Saga stood outside.
Rulo, what do you think?
Palma asked.
Go in,
Saga said, bumping Rulo on his shoulders.
It's okay. I can check out the mechs from here. I know my mechs, so it's chill. Don't need to get closer, Rulo said.
This irked Palma. Now he really had to pretend like he knew what he was doing. He thought of the manual again and riffed off some technical specs.
So, do these have good fuel capacity for training?
Absolutely, Mr. Emmer.
Okay, well, I'm going then with the medium weight one, the best middle ground.
He hoped it would be right for her. Rulo nodded.
Good choice.
Great then, my dears. The championship mechs have to conform to certain regulated standards. I will get a similar sized one with all the correct specs. Would that be sufficient? It can wait a day.
Palma and Rulo nodded.
Are you sure you don't want to check them out? Saga asked.
Palma looked at Rulo for advice.
It should be fine, Rulo added.
Fantastic. I will deliver tomorrow. Such a joy to have my mechs used by a championship runner. On top of that, the daughter of the adept River Kaigo.
Palma felt elated as Mother Mech escorted them back out into the mech hall. Now he just hoped that Flora would accept his help.
It would be awkward if she didn't.